Nice, that's a perfect one.
This is Anishinaabe territory. We're all around the Great Lakes. It's a big part of our lifestyle to be around the lakes.
I'm 53 years old, and the stamp sands have been here since I was young.
We sat in this stuff. We had our kids in it. We had picnics on top of this stuff, you know, not realizing we were sitting on mining waste all that time.
In the Keweenaw Bay of the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, there were a lot of mining activities historically, and what's left over is crushed rock. That crushed rock material is called stamp sands.
At that time, there were no environmental protections. And that ore is lots of things like copper, nickel, silver, cadmium, chromium, arsenic. These stamp sands just are inhospitable to life, to growth of plants. And if you don't have growth of plants, then you don't have insects and you don't have wildlife.
I think that's important for the Anishinaabe principles of life, that we're here to protect and we're here to help the animals and help the plants and the trees.
We've been working out here at Sandpoint for decades, literally decades at this point, trying to address the stamp sand issue.
We found out that you really can't remove it, that you're gonna have to begin growing plants, you know, native to this area on top of it.
And we were at a point where we realized we need to try something new, something innovative, and Ron's project just sounded like exactly what we needed.
For centuries, people have been using trees to clean the environment.
We have these researchers, you know, and these professors, and, you know, a lot of people talking about stuff, and we're just like, whoa, 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 like, what does that all mean? What is phytoremediation?
The trees literally suck up the contamination from the soil, and they either break it down so it's not a problem anymore, or they actually use it for their growth and the processes that they need to live and thrive and survive.
It actually gives me chills thinking about it.
The USDA Forest Service Northern Research Station is partnering with the Keweenaw Bay Indian Community, Michigan Technological University, and the University of Missouri to develop these specific nature-based solutions.
It's like, oh, well, you know, we have these plants and they can take up heavy metals, and that just like kind of blew my mind, like, what? Like, how cool? Like, what an amazing project. We could just encourage this landscape to heal itself, right?
What started as a conversation between Ron and Aaron is now turning into this big project.
It's pretty exciting to be here and see it actually happening in person on the ground.
I'm amazed how efficient the whole team's operate.
This study was funded by the Bipartisan Infrastructure Law for the ecosystem restoration provision.
This kind of research has never been done. There's other locations in the UP that have stamp sands deposits, but this is totally new, totally groundbreaking. That's one of the things that really excites me, the potential for novel discovery.
This project is especially unique. Having the support from the Forest Service helped me to translate some of our findings from the lab into the real-world application that can benefit the community.
We always talk about doing things for seven generations looking forward. You know, what do we want this to be for our children and our children's children?
50 years from now, I hope that my grandkids are enjoying the same things that I did. I hope that they're getting a fish off the point and they're getting to swim in the water.
I'm watching all these people working, you know, for something that they may never see. They're working for the betterment of, you know, our future and the preservation of our area that we all love.